Welcome to HP Tuners Subaru Training Part 5. In this training tutorial, we're going to take a look at our VCM scanner, doing an overview of the software, understanding how our channels work, our chart versus time, and histograms, really making sure that we have the basic fundamentals of the software covered so that when we're starting to use it, things are going to be more familiar. Without further wait, let's jump into our overview so we can check this out. Okay, so let's get started. We're going to be taking a look at our VCM scanner overview here in this tutorial. The VCM scanner is going to be a critical software that we're going to work with. It allows us to data log channels out of our OBD2 port, essentially giving us a data stream. We can take that data and we can plot it here in our VCM scanner software to be able to figure out what is going on with our vehicle. This allows us to get a window into fuel and spark timing and boost control. And by understanding the data here in our VCM scanner software, we know exactly what to change and where to change things in our VCM editor in the actual calibration file. So without working with the scanner, we would be tuning blind. Going in and learning how to work with this is an essential part of the calibration process. Just as understanding which table to edit and to go and make our changes in, we have to know what we're actually doing, what the data is showing us, and that's what the scanner is going to be used for. Now we have a couple other additional features and functions with the scanner. We can do a read code or an erase code feature with the scanner. We'll get into that just a little bit later in the software. But this is going to be a way that we can look at raw data, we can plot the data, we can even work with something called a histogram that's going to allow us to do sensor overlays to really be able to populate tables out very quickly looking at our log data. Again, this is an extremely powerful tool if you know how to use it correctly. So let's go in here and do a basic software overview, and then we're going to start to dig into things a little bit deeper in this tutorial. We will be looking in the next tutorial, taking things to the next level with our VCM scanner, talking about layouts and histograms a little bit further and to make sense of working within the scanner. Again, this is just trying to do more of a basic general overview. So looking in the software here, if we look at the very, very top, we're going to find here we have VCM scanner offline mode. I have the ignition key powered off on my STI right now. It tells me the year, make, model that I'm dealing with, 2018 Subaru STI Limited, and then the VIN number here at the top. Now, if we look down below it, we have these drop-down icons. If we go through here, these are going to allow us access to particular features or functions of the software. Now, down below our drop-downs, we find we have our hot links to be able to open, save files, close files, connect to the vehicle, record or stop. We have our read code function and erase the code function. And then we have some of our zooming features and playback speed features, as well as ways we can save our histograms and layout down here below. Again, we're going to get into that. So let's just jump in here and talk about what we're going to find. So looking here up the top, we have log file. We have an open or closed log file. Now we need to go and create a log file. In order to create a log file, we're going to go in when we actually are powered on with the vehicle. We go here to record. And then once we record and we're finished recording, we can use the stop button. That'll start and stop the scanning. Once we've done a data capture, we can save the file. So that would be here, log file, and we could do save log file as, that saves it to the folder that you're working with. We've created a custom folder in our last tutorials looking in our VCM editor side of things. We would save the log files into that specific folder. Now that allows us to save it. If we want to open up the log file, we go to log open or the close log file. So we can find that functionality here, or we can also find that same functionality again down here. Much easier to do with the icons than in our dropdown. We also have an export log file feature. This allows you to export it out of the file format unique to the VCM scanner software. You can export it as a .csv, which is an Excel-based file. You can open that up in a variety of different data logging softwares as well as working in Excel if you choose to do so. I don't use that feature very often, but it is here. We also have a recent log file option. These are all the recent log files that I've had open over the last probably week or two working within the software. Now, the one thing we have to remember with this software is that it's a universal base logging software for all of the HP Tuners applications. So some of the features and functions we're finding in here won't be applicable to a Subaru. Namely, we have a special vehicle function here that's going to allow us to do certain tasks for GM, Dodge, or Ford tuning. It's not going to exist for the Subaru, so this icon can be illuminated, but when we click on it, there'll be nothing there. I just wanted to point that out, that the software is just, it's used for everything. So some of what we find here may or may not be relevant in terms of what we want to use. Looking here, there's an exit button that just closes the software out. We can find the same functionality here in the upper right-hand corner to close the software if we choose to do so.
Thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.